I warn you, gentlemen, a patient could be a bit violent, so lace him in tightly, please. If he gets a naughty boy, give him a bit of a jab, will you?
Yes, doctor.
Thank you, Bella.
Hey, geez, what do you think you're flaming doing? Yeah, Pommy bastards. Wait, oh, tell me, Auntie Edna.
Now, Mr. McKenzie, you're back with us. How are you? I'm sorry about that little incident. I'm Dr. DeLavsley, and I'm here to help you.
Pull your head in.
I want you to think of me as someone that you can turn towards.
What I've heard of your mob, you won't catch me turning any other way.
Come, come, Mr. McKenzie, let's start at the beginning, shall we? When did you start having delusions?
Well, if you really want to know, it all started when I paid through the nose for a ticket and landed up a shit creek called England.
So, you hate the mother country, do you? What exactly is your relationship with your own mother?
I'm a son.
But what about your sex life? Is it healthy?
Healthy? Flammable should be. Hasn't had a chance to catch anything yet. Look, Doc, if you don't stop shooting off your mouth, I'm going to chunder on you wall to wall.
You'll what?
I'll chunder, so help me. You know, throw the voice, play the whale, laugh at the ground, you know, make love to the lav.
You find my carpet funny? It makes you laugh. Hear me. Which particular part of my carpet amuses you the most?
You're getting warmer.
Would it be this particularly phallic pattern here? Am I any warmer?
You're really hot now, Doc. Cough that, you rotten Pommy bastard.
You must feel free to express your aggressions in whatever way is most natural for you. Bella, Hugo! Mr. McKenzie, I've got some good news for you.
You mean you're dying of cancer?
Yes, but apart from that, I've decided to discharge you. Boys, unlace him and give him back his clothes.
Sorry if you've had a rather uncomfortable day, sir.